nothing too fancy is happening. Since it's literally right. Oh. Interesting and worth checking out. What's 1 XP, you know? Oh wow, that's real closer than I would have expected. We're gonna start needing food. Oh, would you look at that? Leather. And a nest! We shall keep on fighting these. Pop up our shieldy and beefy girl. And our turn. Just do that and that. That would clear about two, should be. And then the third one's gonna die either way, or not. So I will confuse her. Alright, we won, man, we fucked him up. And we even got a equipment, a jewelry, 2 XP, and 1 research. Almost there, we only need a couple more. I am gonna instantly check out that thing. 1 destructive and 1 armor? Few details. And sneak and hunt challenges, damage to the enemy and heals you. Oh, so that's lifesteal for. That's cool. I will got there. My expectations means that. Set up camp, gather. Thank you.
unexpected visitor, Theodore, arrives at your village. Your food stocks have grown. Your people are learning how to live in the awakened fear once more. But the darkness is not gone. Always looming in the shadows, lurking behind corners. It is time to try and find clues as to what happened and how to repair it.
Okay, so how should we do it?
That's the spirit. I knew we could count on you. I must warn you, others have tried and failed before you, so the road will not be easy.
Do you know anything more about what happened to the cosmic tree or why the darkness came?
I know some, but I do not hold the answers you need to seek. I know that once Fear was a land ruled by high magic, a land where demons were kept in check by the peoples. And by the cosmic balance upheld by the gods. The pillars of Thea stood sturdy and held our world together. Now the barriers between the lands of the living and those of the dead are torn asunder. And thus darkness holds a tight grip on us. Without your aid, whatever made the sun return may not hold for long. And the age of darkness may descend upon us once again.
Alright, fine. So how do we find what
there
to do?
There have been those who sought to undo this curse. Those who were charged with the guardianship of Thea's pillars and who have failed us. Some were the ancient peoples you call elves. Some were avatars of your gods. And some, just people who proved worthy. And yet, they all failed thus far. Here, on this map, I marked a spot where one such guardian may hold answers for you. Without giving you a chance to say anything more, Theodore disappears, leaving you with a map.
Okay, we'll take the map. We're going back to town, guys. We're gonna drop stuff off. Oh, wait. I forgot to turn in the quest, man. We're turning the quest first, so... From there, we'll go here. Talk to Theodore. Right. We got the gold for you.
Oh, good. You got the gold. That wretched woman owes me, but I have no desire to speak to her. Anyway, it's a matter of principles rather than the gold itself, so just keep it. You may need it to craft better stuff, you know.
Thanks, so what now?
Social challenges, as you saw, you will face your opponent, but different skill sets become relevant, such as speech, attractiveness, and will. So just remember, different challenges use different skills. And so your party composition can have a great impact on the way you explore the world. As you perhaps noticed, you got research points as well as XP. You need research points to discover new materials and recipes for crafting and new buildings for your village.
Right, so I get both the experience and research points by exploring and even killing stuff? Got it.
Now, you will notice that some equipment as well as buildings in your village require a lot of stuff. Often things that are not easily gathered or commonly found. For such needs, I also recommend scouring the world map in search of old ruins, abandoned tunnels, ancient towers. You get the gist, right? It so happens that I know of an old dungeon that you can explore and loot. I have marked this place on your map.
Thanks. So rare materials are also found in the world throughout both events and places of interest. Is there any more I can bring you? Anything more I can bring you?
Well, yes, I have a second task for you to do at any time you're ready. Craft me 10 cooked, baked, or roasted food. Any type. You may want to research some varieties as well to match your supplies. Also, leave these 10 crafted foods in the village until I show up. You don't have to rush with this one. Take your time and get to grips with managing your settlement. Remember to check the magical help button to read more. Yeah, I know. More about any mechanics.
Alright. Explore dungeons, crack 10 cooked, baked, or roasted food. Till later then. 3 XP. Oh, did you see that? I got her XP. For a thing point. he wanted that, so that's what I'll do. Now I will return home, drop my stuff off, and then go about equipping. For now, I guess. Well, stay here for a little bit to be able to, why not, but I think everyone just leveled up. Let's go check. Yep. Let's see. Murgot, Grislof, Rhoda, Brotra, Britmir, and Lidna are here. Healthier, but Lidna is healthier by one more than the others. Visla is better at, by one strength, not, Yuza is more good at gathering. Damn, she's being a good gatherer now, ain't she? Literally, she has 5 at gathering. She's pretty good at gathering now. Literally, boom. Oh, you got wood for days, boys. Great, lead the teacher creature to its task. I'm pretty sure those are... blessings are removed over time, right? Yeah. So for 15 turns, he has +3 magic. And 2 XP, wow, thanks.
Made your first batch of prepared food. No longer are you a mere scavenger. Now you can cook. Crafted foods are more efficient than the raw stuff, so you may want to take them when you're out exploring, as they are lighter to carry. So now I have a harder task for you. Build me a building in your village.
Alright, one building to build, off we go. 2 XP and 2 research.
Was once celebrated during midsummer when the sun shone brightest.
the seasons have changed for the Darkness Treasure Lord, but it's time for the first Kapala night since the Sun's return. Right, get the celebrations underway then.
The Night of Kupala has many faces and traditions that need to be upheld. Bonfires are lit with sticks and stones and placed on hillsides or other high places around the settlement. Offerings of food and animal stock are made in honor of the many gods. Music, dance, and laughter accompany the night's rituals. But the main event is chosen by the village elders with each solstice. There are several ways to celebrate the night and prove yourselves. Some may take more time, some may be risky. Doing nothing is not an option.
Go swimming in the lakes or rivers at night under the protection of the Kapala celebration. These waters will be safe and they can give you strength and prosperity. My options are find pure flower, the flower of the fern that blooms only after a thunderstorm, and has within it the strength of Purun. Make a well for flowers and hair and put a lit candle within it and then send it down the river to find love and new hope for tomorrow. Create a large bonfire, burn herbs and food offerings in it, and then have your people jump through the flame so that people they may be cleansed but also prove their bravery to gods. Go swimming in the lakes, I'm very well in that. Oh, bah! Nobody tells we must do something? Do nothing! I'm going forth.
It is a well-known fact that those who go swimming idly, especially at night, can fall prey to the many water demons lurking in the dark depths. But on the night of Kupala, the power of the gods protects you, and in their honor, customary to bathe in water under the moonlight in order to cleanse your bodies and souls.
Great, go for the swim then!
You feel your god's warm embrace upon you as you swim in the waters, and your bodies are cleansed of any curses. As you revel in the rare pleasure of safety, a creature swims up to you and speaks quickly before disappearing. You honor my waters with your god's presence. You chased off an evil that long plagued me here. In fact, seek out my treasure in the rivers of fear. You also find your fisherman bringing bountiful harvest for the festivities.
Right, so there may be a treasure somewhere in a river. Perhaps one day you'll find it if you search through as rivers. Production, crafting, building. Gonna want another pastor. Boom, boom, and then boom. I mean, sure. Build it again. Sure. finish?
Well done. You have your very first buildings. As you can see, it takes many resources to build a decent abode. Or perhaps your god gifted you, in which case you cheated. Remember, the better the minerals you use, the better the bonuses from your buildings. You have a limit of 10 buildings, but you can demolish the old ones to make way for new. One of the ways to win over the darkness is for you to research more recipes, grow your population, and build more houses. So get going.
Thanks, Theodore. All done now. Plus 2 XP and plus 2 research. Open God progress. Explore the places marked for clues. Production, so. Saved! Finally, I actually finally saved, by the way, yay! I will actually check to see, nope, okie dokie, I have no research. Production, crafting. Tax option, construction. I will actually put you on to help, or not. I will make you start here. That way, you can go boom, boom, and speed it up by one more turn. Yes, I'm just speeding it up. I'm gonna turn on the fan, so if you hear it, I'm sorry, but it's hot in here. Okay, my options are follow the cat or better not. I have 3 unavailable. I'm gonna go with follow the cat. My options are take the child or leave. I'm taking the child.
And the cat turns into a ray of light that surrounds the child and then disappears. You feel your village blessed.
I have 1 more child, and everyone, most of the people got a bonus health for 25 turns. Plus 2 XP and 1 research. Enemy spotted, a spooter. I will actually tech building. 1 more turn.
An unusually big and strange looking black rooster was seen perusing your village barn. You suspect this may be a Kroopsi, a domesticated field demon who can bring great fortune to its host. But beware, if it deems you to be a bad farmer, it may instead damage your crops or play nasty tricks.
Leave an opening in your barn wall for the Kroopsi to come in and come out easily. Shut the barn totally. No, they for Trixie option, demons. I will do number 1.
The Kroopsi seems happy with your work, and so your people bring in more crops from the fields, and your gardens give more fruit.
Oh, hell yeah, great! 2 XP! 10, 10, and I'm still knitting, yarn, and whatnot. Yeah. I'm gonna create an expedition force. Of course, I'm gonna take you. What did I get before? Yeah, Elena. Full gathering. I'll take you. Three fighters, one gatherer, one crafter, and one man. Boom, and bam, boom. And we will go and instantly deal with them. We will instantly attack, because it's only spooters. Put her as first, and then in my turn, and have her do first action. Yeah, she is enough to kill at least two. First action, and then she. Hold on. So next turn, I will deploy her. And let's see how this works. So far, so good, darn it. Yep. And the damage taken. I got one spider silk and one amulet. I'm gonna view details. It is concentration. That's good. One gathering and one armor. Ooh. I'm not gonna dismantle that. And I'm instantly gonna view and go to equipment and equip that to my gatherer. Because we. Why wouldn't I? No one gonna talk to you. Hold on, guys. I'm doing something right now. You won't be able to see what I'm doing, though. I'm looking something real fast. It shouldn't take long. Alright, I'm back. I only have one option because two others are unavailable, so I will approach the house. The hammering stops and a dwarf walks out to greet you. That's far enough, strangers. You do not want to anger Chael. She gets very jumpy, that one. The pile of rocks opens its eyes and stares at you. It's definitely a rock troll. I will, I'm not going to be able to win that fight. So we're just passing by. We got your invite. Our village is not far from here, but we've never seen you. A what now?
Well, it's kind of embarrassing. You know, us fallen dwarves, that is, the ones who stayed behind when the darkness came, we tend to be solitary types, at least when it comes to females. After all, no dwarven woman chose this outfit, at least not one I know of. In any case, the story cut short. There is a cute demon girl, a nice type, mind you, living nearby, and, well, I tried impressing her with my smithing, but she doesn't like weapons. I tried sweet talking, but turns out they ain't my best feature. So if you go and convince her to go out with me, I will give you the prize.
Okay, point me in her direction, or you're kidding, what? I will do, okay, point me. Okay, you are serious? Let's do it.
Excellent. Here's a map of the local area. I marked roughly the spots where she hangs out, but I think she may be on the move with her sister, so just, yeah, watch out.
Her sister, whatever, fine. Off I go to convince the demon to date a note dwarf. Plus 3 XP. Ooh, that's a little far. So I shall go that way. And end my turn. And explore more this way. Exploring! I will go up here to see this stuff out. Go here to actually do the room. Search. Oh, hell yeah! Take your loot and exit the building. 2 XP and 1 research. End my turn. Hi there. Well, just leave at it. Nice, take the bronze. Present. I got an amber. 2 XP and 1 research. From here, we'll go here.
You come across a hidden stash, and it looks like whatever is inside may still be intact.
I'll take
you
this up.
You have your loot safe in hand, but you can hear something approaching fast. Perhaps a guardian of the stash. You have time to run, but maybe the creature hides more goodies.
I'm gonna try a level 3 fight.
Stand your ground and face the approaching enemy. The air seems to get thicker, the ground feels shaky, and a sudden raising of the fog makes it hard to see who your assailant is.
Attack fight? Ooh, wild boars. They're beefy mother truckers, aren't they? I have 2 options. I will play you. Okay, you're dead. And play you. And then skip. Oh god. And support ally. Yeah, that's one. And hit select. Ouch. We won, but at what cost?
Turns out these were simply some bulls defending their turf, searching for prey. Still, you search their remains, hoping to gather some extra resources.
We got a collar? Backstabbing gathering. Cool. Monster bones. This wicker. 3 XP and 1 thing. We will go here.
You enter an underground complex that turns out to be some old, long-forgotten dungeon. I'm not sure what used to be the purpose of these dungeons, but they seem large.
Explore.
Inside, there are two main tunnels leading deeper into the complex.
Go left.
You take a left and go down a long, winding corridor, with empty alcoves spread about in equal spaces, each alcove hiding a potential doorway to explore. Such opening, and you arrive at a small, empty chamber. You are about to leave when a ghost stands in your way. I am Sarazar. Please don't go yet. My spirit has been trapped here for decades. I cannot leave here, you see, because everywhere I go, I bring disease and death with me.
Disease and death?
I do not want to do this.
Help. Disease and death? Oh no!
No, no, wait. In this chamber, and only here, I do not spread the filthy blade.
Well, I don't know, or okay, it does sound terrible, so we'll help. That's what
all
I'm doing.
All you have to do is to really let me touch you. I know this is asking much, but if you win with the disease, and I think you will, I will reward you, I swear. Once you have healed, I will no longer bear my curse of Sarissa. I wasn't only once a friendly demon helping people. If you help, I will bless your entire party. You will be healthier for a time, but if you fail,
fine, we'll try it. Begin combat? Oh boy. Oh boy. Should have done you first. Fine. I'll play one. I was trying to glitch the system. That didn't work. What I'm gonna do that is boom. boom. That way he has to hit through them two to even get to them. There's your armor. There's... Ouchies. There's 2 HP also. There's an ouchie to you by 2. Good job. And you're dead. It works just like that, folks. You gotta strategize in your head.
You've beaten the sickness. The Zarathar changes before your very eyes, and from a ghostly wraith, she takes on the form of a healthy young woman. Thank you. Here is my blessing, as promised. If you ever come back here, you may find my sisters. Do try to help them, too. Now I must go. She then changes into a black cat and runs through the walls.
Ooh, Lubna and Anlina has get a permanent HP boost, while the others have gotten a HP boost for 20 down. Plus 2 XP and 1 research.
You enter.
Explore.
Inside, there are 2.
Go right.
You take the right turn and go down a wide corridor with many doors on both sides. You try one of the chambers, and you see it must have been some old jail, as there are many.
Explore.
To the ruins, but realize
damn, leave. Come here. And go there.
You find the skeletal remains of a person, most likely an elf, as the bones have a slight silver tinge and are much lighter than any other humanoid bones you know. On the body, you discover a scroll that unrolls as soon as you touch it. There is a smell of burning wood in the air, and the scroll itself seems to be warm to the touch.
I read it and says throwing it away.
With it, the world burned alike. For as the canopy burned, so did the skies turn red, and the heavens were no more. As the core burned, the earth scorched, fields turned to ash, and fear became a wasteland. Finally, as the roots burned, so did the gates to the underworld, and thus the souls of the dead could find no refuge, no peace, no purpose. You see some notes scribbled on the side of the scroll.
Read all the side notes carefully, or just read the main bits, no need for the fluff. I'll read all the side notes carefully.
One is written in a beautiful style, impeccable, neat, and very distinct. It reads, "And so our duty failed. Did we fail our charges? Did we abandon them too soon? Or were we never supposed to do so in the first place? Should we have guarded the sacred pillars more vigorously? I must go to the Evergreen Grove and find answers." Signed, Alicia Silveroak, Scholar of the Age of Thunderer, Keeper of the Knowledge, Last of the Sacred Guardians. There is an old map with the grove marked upon it. It won't be easy to follow after all this time, but you do recognize some landmarks. There are also 5 pieces of silver tree bark, which the elves seek to diminish our work. No surprise there. I must get to this grove before they can meddle with mankind again. The Sage Tower should give me some clues as to how to stop the elves. The darkness is a side effect for sure, but I'll be damned if I let the magic rule man again. The rest of the notes are too damaged to read.
Right, so there's our 2 locations to scout. Perhaps we should check them out. 4 XP and 1 research. There's me a level up. Cosmic Tree. Where's the other one? Smithy. I will sit by for now. And we will check who leveled up or what they got. Birdmere is 2 more injectors. Lubna is 1 more strengthier. Bird is 1 more healthier. Elena is 1 more. Speech better. Lubna Duba is 1 stealthier. Rada Krum is strength by 1. Brzak is strength by 2. Yuza and Murigod is strength by 1. Or healthier by 1. Horned bats, ravens, crow, and crazed bees. We will begin battle. I will deploy you and have you go first action. I will deploy you and just wait. There we go. Pain Boys is dead. I got that and one sword, and Virgil received one wound and one XP and one research. I'm gonna check that sword out. 2 damage and 5 shielding. I am going to actually dismantle for the resources. Go. We got concentration, gathering, and armor, backstabbing, and gathering. We gotta have them heal, so... Okay, Doki...
You arrive at a tall stone.
Go in.
You walk into the lower floors of the tower. The room is dark and dingy. The walls are filled with bookshelves, barely holding under the weight of the thousands of words that you think must be housed here. There is a desk and some chairs, and the old man sits behind it. Come in, sit and let us talk. I am Professor Anthony Hufka, formerly of the Grand University. These days, well, on research leave, I suppose.
Hello, we found this old scroll by body. It talks about curing the darkness, and it had your tower marked on the map. No, we have not spoken with the elf yet.
Right. Well, he is a wise one. I will grant him that. But his version of history is... history is written by the victors, yes? The Elves have been the victors for many thousands of years, and thus they do write our history. I, however, believe it is time we wrote our own.
What do you mean? You're not making sense.
Well, the elves will tell you that the cosmic tree is one of the pillars of the world. I won't go into it. They know it better. They are correct on that, but sometimes pillars must fall in order to build a new house, you know.
Still not making much sense.
Right. I am an old man, too old for human existence. I forget myself. So it was us, humans, that burned that damned tree. Yes, we at the Grand University. We had a multinational conference and we came to a conclusion. Magic is stifling humanity.
What?
Listen to me. Magic and its prime stewards, the elves, they are keeping us from truly evolving, from reaching our own potential. We can finally be free from superstition, from dark magic, from monsters. We will build a civilization based on reason and knowledge. And yes, this will be costly. Magic will take with it many creatures, not all bad, but humanity will finally be free.
Kill the many, but free the humans? Just the humans? No, that's too idealistic. Like, nothing will go wrong even for us. You sound mad. How's this darkness good for us? We almost died out there.
That is because something went wrong, you see. The tree lingers on. Magic is growing again. The elves are cursed, but still alive. The plan did not work. So you must do whatever that elf tells you, but then find a way to finish the job. Do whatever you must to kill magic and destroy the tree for good.
No thank you.
You will do what you will do, but I trust your brains will win over superstition. And I told you, I don't leave this tower. If I do, I am dead, and I rather like living.
Isn't that magic?
Details. Whatever you do will not happen overnight, you know. It may take generations to fully take its course. I will live until that time and gather knowledge. Now go. No time to waste on an old man.
Wait. We have more questions.
You find yourself standing in an empty field.
Okay, well, let's continue on. Now we return home. Why? Because I can. Oh god. It's just this? Okay. Oh, look at that. You have won! Yay! I got a shield, bone, and an axe, and 5 wounds, 1 XP, 1 research. And another encounter, 5 Hulking rats. Hell yeah, let's start first. Woo-woo. We won again! Baking, leather, XP, and research. Oh, hush, Rosie. What do I keep in against the day? Zoe. One XP and one research again, like I said. We leveled up and gained a research. Let's see, expedition, results, more perception, Bardrum's more strength. Lugna and Elena is more healthier. I just... oof. I oofed. I can't even tell you what they did because I oofed that bad. I'm gonna research. Spotter silk. Confirm. For now. And that's where I go. I'll go over there after I get back in town. Actually, I'll go there first. Medic, crafting, gatherer, or warrior. I'm gonna get me another gatherer. And got one XP for that. Yay! I'm gonna actually check that card. Get out. No. There we go. Crafting. There we go. Ooh, boy. Yeah, you're fucked. You're dead. You're dead. No matter what you do, boy. Get closer. There are a little counter tactics. Or not. I will come to tactics. I will deploy and then deploy. I will also remove a Zoe from the room because she keeps getting in here. I wonder how that battle went so far. Any damages? Yep. A little bit, but yep. I have one. Yay! A shield, meat, and 5 wounds. I will actually look at that shield. Three armor chips shielding.
You continue your journey in hopes it was just a cat.
Yeah, continue on. Checking out. Attack. Attack. For Melissa spotters. Get closer. One free kill. I'm rushing to my teammate. It's defense. Search for the ruins for your field.
Stirring whatever comes inside by the side.
Fucking battle. Oh, yeah. Oof. Poison and life leech that's gonna kill us. I see what the damage dealer is. GG game. GG, I lost that bout. Like I figured I lost. This is Matt signing off. Bye-bye.